Now that I'm a Gold 1 player, you guys might be wondering how I did it. Let me tell you. Drag back, then I ball roll, then I drag back. Okay, drag back, then I ball roll, then I drag back. Hold up.
Players see my team and they think that I spend money. Transfer profit high, so high that my nose blows. Yeah, yeah. I pass on my test, but believe that I don't. Drag back, see defenders all day, like a whole
I'm
cookie.
Coming.
I went in the lay, I don't cook. I souffle, bury chances on my chances near post every day. R1, then I flick my stick down. You can have Van Dyke, but I'ma leave you clown, boy.
What is going on, YouTube? It is your boy, One Star Week Foot, reporting to you live from the sweatiest parts of the weekend league. I mean, literally, it is 85 degrees where I'm living at. But we are here today with another episode of the Broke Boy Road to Glory. Thank you very much for tuning in. I appreciate all you guys for rocking with this series. I mean, we are 132, 133 episodes deep and you guys still here. So big ups to everybody for clicking the video. As you guys know, today is Bundesliga team of the season. And yo, I burnt the team down. I have sold a bunch of players and I am trying a bunch of new players out. Let me show you guys the transfer list real quick just so you're in tune with some of the new stuff I've done. So Richarlison had to go. I mean, I'm an Everton fan, and Richarlison is an Everton legend, but I do like to try new cards. So Richarlison sold 1.6 million. I bought him for 1.7, and just as every week, I made a loss selling them. It is what it is. I mean, that's pretty much the market in FIFA 20 right now, so I'm not mad at it. We bought Giovinco once again for about 390. We sold him for 257. Once again, a major L. But Giovinco was a fun card, so I'm not mad at it. We sold Aguero, 36,250 coins. David Silva still needs to sell. And I sold this guy. I forgot what pack I got him in. I think it was Marquee Matchups or something. But I sold him, 6,700. Thank you very much. And yeah, you might be wondering to yourself what I did with the coins. I mean, that's a lot of coins you just seen me making from selling players. You know what? I'm gonna stop the suspense. This is the new squad we are rocking with, boasting four new players. As you can see here, we got Hugo Sanchez, Moments card. And the one difference between this Sanchez and the other Sanchez cards is the composure. 87 composure is a massive upgrade. Even if they didn't touch any other stat on his prime card, the fact that they gave him 87 composure is a much, much needed upgrade on that card. Of course, we got Militao. We got Ter Stegen, 95 rated, perhaps the best goalkeeper on this game. We got Muller, 95 rated. My first time ever using a team of the season Muller. I feel like he gets one every year. This is my first time using him. And I gotta say, he's a very interesting card. I'll be talking about him tomorrow. We also are trying another new German Bayern player, Gnabry. Team of the season version. And this card looks absolutely mental. I bought him for 619, which I thought wasn't a bad price. But the main man, the star of the show, is gonna be the SBC they dropped today. 93 rated flashback Witzel. And I mean, if anything, he is absolutely worth it just for that dynamic image alone. I mean, that looks quite sexy, if I do say so myself. But let's look at this card. He's 6'1". He has medium-high work rates. He's right-footed with a four-star combination. I played 7 games in Division Rivals with him, and I got 4 goals and 0 assists from a CDM position in a 4-triple-2. Before we go any further, if you're enjoying the content, if you want more content like this, do me a favor, hit the like button down below. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing to the channel. I appreciate all you guys at home for watching this video. So, I mean, when you look at this Witzel card, he looks insane. He looks like a poor man's Vieira with the defending, the physical, the body type. If you've ever used any Witzel on this game, whether it's Footmas Witzel, whether it's UCL Witzel, whether it's regular plain old Witzel, you know, he's pretty big in game. He has a big body type, and that does help him go into a challenge. And I expect him to be massive in the midfield with these defending and physical stats in addition to that. His dribbling stats are very nice, and this is what separates him from Vieira, in my opinion. Vieira feels stiff on the ball, and that's why a lot of people don't use him this year. I mean, Vieira is somebody that's used every year, but this year he's taking a back seat to players like Seedorf, to players like Hullet, to players like Essien, because they're more agile than him. This Witzel card does have some very nice dribbling stats. We're gonna see how it plays out in game though. His passing stats are very nice. I really enjoy that. And his shooting. I mean, if you want a CDM that can overlap and score you some goals, I mean, I got 4 goals with him, so you should know his shooting looks pretty decent as well. The one key stat here that I was worried about was the acceleration. Is 76 acceleration going to be a problem? I mean, I did throw a shadow cam style on him to help that out because I thought that was his main weakness. So yeah, we're going to jump into the gameplay. I'm going to let you guys know how I'm doing in the weekend league, and I'm going to let you guys know, is this whistle card worth it? Let's go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this card is going to be costing you 130,000 coins on the PS4 market. Is he worth the money? I'd have to say absolutely. I think it's a great value. Is he a top tier CDM? I would say not quite, but he's very good. Definitely weekend league worthy. I mean, for 130,000 coins, you can't go wrong. We're going to break down the stats though, so you know exactly what to expect at home. So he has 83 picks. And like I said, the one thing I was worried about was his acceleration. It was 76, which I boosted theoretically to 91 with a shadow cam style and in-game. He felt decent, all right? He felt good enough to track up and down the pitch. And he was helped out a lot by the fact that he does have a lot of length. He has those Vieira spider legs. So he's able to cover a lot of ground naturally just because of his body type, his stature, everything like that. That being said though, his acceleration I found to be an issue at times, like if I was getting countered very quickly. He did take a little bit of time to get going, and that's a common trend with pretty much players with big body types in game, so I'm not surprised. Overall though, I have to say his pace is decent. I gotta give it an 8 out of 10. Next we're gonna talk about shooting, and like I said, this guy looks like a CDM that can overlap. He has 80 shooting, or not 80 shooting, 80 finishing. And in game, his finish inside the box was very reliable. If you get it from a good angle, chances are it's going to hit the back of the net, especially when you consider he has the 88 shot power. So he does his job in that regard. He has very good attack positioning, which is something I really noticed. I left him on balanced instructions, and he made a lot of late runs into the box that were well timed, that were well placed, and that allowed him to score the goals. I mean, a lot of my opponents were busy marking my Mueller, they were busy marking my Sanchez, and when this whistle found himself in the box, he was open and he was banging the back of the net. He also has some good long shots as well. Overall, I do have to give this guy shooting an 8 out of 10. It's solid. Don't get too excited with it. Don't try some crazy shots. But if you try it from a good angle, he will hit the back of the net. Next, we're going to talk about his passing. And this is the thing that really stood out to me about this card. He has 99 short passing. He has 93 long passing. And in game, this guy felt very, very good as far as passing goes. He's very much a deep lying playmaker if you want to make him one. And the waiting on his passes is what really stood out. Whether it was a driven pass under pressure, whether it was a soft pass, whether it was an over the top through ball, they were all weighted perfectly for the attacker to just run on them. Overall, I gotta give this guy's passing a 9 out of 10. I really enjoyed this aspect of the card. Next, we're gonna talk about his dribbling, and this was another concern of mine. He's 6'1", and his dribbling stats are very good, but how does it feel in game? And I would say when the gameplay is delayed, do not try to turn with this guy. He will feel very clunky as far as turning goes in delayed gameplay. The first few games I played in this weekend league were some of the most delayed games I played in a long time. And this whistle card was not doing me any favors with his big turning radius and his mediocre agility and balance. That being said, when the gameplay is smooth, he's able to pull off a skill move or two. He's able to pull off the scoop turn very decently. And he does have a good ball control. He has good, he has 93 ball control, 86 dribbling. So when he L1 dribbles, if you dribble in the right way, if you don't do anything too crazy, then I think he's a fairly decent dribbler. He's a fairly press-resistant midfielder, and you gotta keep that in mind when you're using him. He has 99 composure, which is insane. It makes him very good when passing, when shooting, even under pressure. And he has great reactions at 94, which helps him in all aspects of his game. I will say his dribbling is an 8 out of 10. He's decent for a CDM. He does feel decent on the ball, but at the same time, when the gameplay is delayed, do not move with him. Just don't. Next, we're going to talk about his defending and physical, and this is the part of his card that is elite, I have to say. The impact he made defending-wise was insane. He felt like a Vieira in the game. He cut passing lanes with the best of them. I mean, all his defensive stats are pretty much 99 with the shadow chem style threw on him, and it did feel like that. His break of play was insane. It's not only his interception stat, it's not only his defensive awareness stat, but it's just the fact that he does have these long, long legs. It allows him to just come to life and grab a ball that doesn't look like it's in his reach. average. He has a great stand tackle as well. He has 95 stand tackling, 92 strength, 88 aggression. Those are three stats I always place together because they're very relevant together. And in going into the challenge, he was massive. I mean, he would just barge people off the ball. But at the same time, he was clean enough to come away with the ball once he barged them off the ball. I really enjoyed that. Overall, this guy's defending and physical ability is a 9.5 out of 10. He is very much a Vieira substitute if that's what you want. All right, guys, so what's the final verdict on this card? I think for 130,000 coins, he's a great value. I think the best way to use him is to have him sit in front of the defense and just pretty much shield the back four. I think that's where he's really going to excel the most. And he'll be able to push the ball up a bit. He'll be able to spray a through ball if you like to counter. I really think that's the best way to make use of his abilities. Because in the delayed gameplay, you will notice his lack of agility, his lack of balance, and overall big turning radius. And it did let me down at times in the tight games, in the delayed games, and everything like that. Overall, I got to give him an 8.5 out of 10. He's a great value. He's not the most meta card in the game. He's not the most top tier card of the game, but he does excel at a few things, and those things are very important as it stands. All right, guys, so you might be wondering how I'm doing in the weekend league, and we've been taking it easy. I mean, I started playing today around 8 p.m. It was 85 degrees in New York today, so I'm not trying to play FIFA when the weather outside is nice for once. So I went out, I played FIFA late, and the gameplay was pretty bad. I'm not gonna lie. I would say 4 out of 7 games had really, really bad delay. And the only way you can play in that delay is just to hold possession, hope your opponent makes a bad decision defensively, and just try to exploit it. I mean, it's just very boring, dry, redundant gameplay. And that's why I only stopped at 7 games. I couldn't really do it anymore. I finished at 5-2, which it is what it is. I don't know if I could take this game seriously this weekend. I just don't know if I can do it. I am going to push at least for gold 3. I'll try for gold 2, gold 1. But if it doesn't happen, you know what? It is what it is. I'm just going to enjoy my FIFA the best way I can. All right, guys. So that's going to be Broke Boy episode number 133. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed it or found it helpful. Once again, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next episode. But until then, later.